If you look at the current top 10 in the prime charts, you'll see the top 10 largest primes at the moment, and you may notice that one of them stands out. One of them is not quite like the others. It's quite a special prime. It was actually discovered fairly recently. It was discovered on October the 31st, 2016. It was discovered on Halloween, 2016. But all the other primes are Mersenne primes, all primes that are one less than a power of two. And there's a reason for that, because computationally, it's quite easy to check if they are primes or not, right? There is a test for that, which you can run quite quickly. Number seven there is slightly different. There's a couple of reasons why it's special, and one of the reasons is that it takes us one step closer to solving a 50-year-old conjecture. So let's take a look at this prime. So this number, it's called a Proth prime. So Proth primes have this form where it's k, that's some number, multiplied by a power of 2 plus 1. Let's see if we can find a Proth prime. What I'm going to do, let's take a value, I'm going to say k is 19, all right? Let's take k as 19. And then we're going to multiply it by powers of 2, add 1, and let's see if we get a prime. Well, let's do the first power of 2. 19 times 2, 38 plus 1, that equals 39, but that's not a prime. It's 3 times 13, that's no good. Let's check for another. Let's try 19 again, but let's do 2 squared. So 19 times 4, well, 19 times 2 is 38, so we can double that again. That's 76 plus 1, that's 77, that's definitely not a prime. That's 7 times 11. Let's keep going, let's see if we can find one. Let's do 19 times 2 to the power 3. That is 153. 153, is that prime? That's maybe not so obvious, but no, that isn't prime. 19 times 2 to the power 4. Okay, we're gonna keep looking. I think that is plus 1, of course. That is 305. That's definitely not a prime. Okay, another failure. Let's keep looking for a prime. Let's do the next one. 19 times 2 to the 5 plus 1. I've got that's been 609. No, that's divisible by 3.
I think you're gonna get us on that top 10 list at this rate.
It's gonna actually, we've got it. We've got it. Look at this one. 19 times 2 to the power 6, 1,217 prime. That is a prime. Finally, we found a prime. Took a while, yeah. It took a while, but eventually we found a prime. In the 1960s, a mathematician, Sierpinski, said that if you take something of this form, it's k times 2 to the power n plus 1, and you keep running through it, there are numbers that will never hit a prime. So you'll keep going forever, and you'll never get a prime. In fact, he said there were infinitely many of them. So there's loads of them out there. The natural question is, what's the smallest one? Ah, well, we don't quite know. So they think it might be this number, 78,557.
As k?
Yeah, that's as k. So I'm saying if we multiply that by 2 to the n and then we add 1 and we run through that process, we'll never hit a prime. It's never going to happen. In fact, I know that's never going to happen. So a mathematician called John Selfridge showed that that's never going to happen. He showed that this number, whatever it is, will always be divisible by one of these, 3, 5, 7, 13, 19, 37, or 73. So he said he's always going to be divisible by one of those, so it's never going to be a prime. That definitely is a Sierpinski number. Okay, this is a number that will never hit a prime. Great, but is it the smallest one? That we don't know. Now, there's quite a few candidates for this. Well, in fact, we're going to have to check all the numbers smaller than 78,557. Well, you can do that. And most of those were eliminated. Until around about the beginning of the 21st century, there were 17 left. 17 that hadn't been eliminated. So they might be numbers that are smaller than 78,557, and you could do this and you'll never hit a prime. So there were 17 candidates left. But thanks to advances in computation, that meant we could start eliminating these candidates. Now, we started to eliminate them until there were 6 left. These are the 6 that were left. The smallest was 10,223. But here are the others. 21,181, 22,699, 24,737, 55,400, and 59. And 67,607. So there were these six candidates left. But things started to slow down, and I'm afraid there was a gap of 9 years before we were able to eliminate one of these six, which was this one here, 10,223, because we now know that forms a prime. Here's our prime, this is it. There it is, we know it does form a prime. So now this is struck off the list, leaving five left. Now, if we can eliminate those last five candidates, we will have proved that 78,557 is the smallest Sierpinski number.
So James, was this really large prime not so much found because they were searching for large primes, but because they were trying to eliminate Ks?
That is part of the motivation for this. This was found by a guy in Hungary on his home computer, where he's downloaded a program. You can get it from the Prime Grid website. And this program was designed to eliminate those 17 that I talked about. And using that program, he finally eliminated 10,223. So you can do this yourself using your own home computer. So he gets the glory of solving that and the glory of striking off one of these candidates off our list. So we have these candidates, and then you find a prime that kills it off as a candidate. So those primes are huge. This one that was found recently is over 9 million digits long. It's a massive number. Right? The largest of these primes that are killing off our candidates, they've actually got a special name. They're called Colbert primes, named after Stephen Colbert. Stephen Colbert, some people might know as the host of The Late Show in America, American comedian. I don't know why these have been named after Stephen Colbert. I guess someone's a fan. But if we can eliminate all these candidates, we will have proven that 78,557 is the smallest Sierpinski number. We don't know it's true, it just feels true. In our guts, it has truthiness.
Obviously, we love these videos about arbitrary numbers and obscure details, but to see how everything fits together, to get that bigger picture, why not check out brilliant.org? Here's just the start of their number theory course. It's full of little questions and puzzles that are not only good fun, but really help you get your head around stuff. And have a look at that. How can this not be quickening your pulse rate? Whether you're really serious about mathematics or you just love to learn, Brilliant's interactive site is going to teach you all sorts of amazing stuff that you might not get from, say, just a superficial video. Not that there's anything wrong with videos, of course. Keep watching these too. But seriously, I honestly think you'll enjoy what these guys have made. It's a really, really good resource. It's also just really good fun to play with. If you'd like to check them out, go to brilliant.org/numberphile. The first 314 people who do and sign up can get 20% off the premium annual subscription. That's the first 314. See what we did there? They don't just cover mathematics, there's astronomy, physics, computer science, all sorts of good stuff. Thank you to them for supporting this video, and I'll put some details in the video description.